On the 22nd of January, Asimo announced on Twitter that Jailbreak would be receiving a graphical update, including pictures you can see on screen. This was possible because of Roblox updating their Future is Bright project to Phase 2.5, which allows for even more realistic lighting in any game. To do this ourselves, let's hop into one of our games in Roblox Studio. Don't forget that I have a tutorial series playlist that you can find in the description for anything else you'd like to learn. If this lighting ends up causing too much lag for some players in your game, they can turn down the graphics quality in the Settings tab when they hit Escape in game, and it will act like the normal lighting from before this update, so you don't need to worry about this deterring some players from your game. To start, we need to make sure that the edit quality in Roblox Studio is set to higher than level 11, or else you won't be able to see shadows correctly when editing the game. Head to File at the top left of the screen, then click on Settings, and then the Rendering button on the left tab, and from here, you can change your edit quality level to any level over 11 so you could get these shadows, and I'm going to be using the highest level, level 21, for the sake of this tutorial. Now, make sure that the Explorer and the Properties are enabled, which you can do through the View tab at the top left of the screen. Now, click on Lighting, then go into the Properties GUI, and from here, there are three sections that are important to make sure this effect is seen in-game, which are under the Appearance and Data sections. Before we adjust any settings, it's recommended to be using either voxel or shadow map technology at the bottom of the Appearance section to get the most out of these shadows. I'm going to be using shadow map here since it's the more realistic out of the three. The main sliders you'll be using are the environmental diffuse scale, which affects the brightness of the environment based on the objects around it, and the environmental specular scale, which makes objects reflect more light the higher it goes, like a mirror. When changing these settings, keep in mind that cranking both up to the max might make your game look weird until you've adjusted the ambient and outdoor ambient settings to lower values that have darker colors, like 000 for black, along with the time of day, which can be found in the data section. If you're noticing a weird tint in your game, it may also be caused by the skybox you have in your lighting, if it has a much lighter color, especially towards nighttime. I'll put a link in the description under the important links section to some of the skyboxes that Roblox has published in the library. And before we adjust anything else, as you can see from the car here, it has a very strong effect when in contact with the sun, and if I go back into the lighting and I turn this specular scale down all the way to zero, you'll see the huge difference it has on your game. From here, make sure you change these settings around a bit to make sure that having this kind of lighting works during any time of day, if your game has day and night cycles, or even if you keep it at one time of day. To do this, go to the Properties section again, go down to Data, and for the time of day, you can adjust the clock time slider, which can be changed all the way from 0 to 24, which goes back to 0. And I'm going to bring it over here to this time. And as far as the geographic latitude goes, this changes the position of the sun in the sky. So if I go here and I change it a little bit, it's going to change the angle it's at so that now the sun is hitting everything a little bit differently. If you notice that it gets too dark during the nighttime, you can also adjust the brightness at the top of the appearance section to a slightly higher value if you're not looking to add in-game lights like lampposts and that kind of stuff. The environmental diffuse scale is extremely important when it comes to later times of day, especially since if it's on zero, it makes it nearly impossible to see anything inside of your game. I'll show you how some of these materials look at different times of day, since some change more than others. The materials that are most affected by this are the metallic textures and foil, while some of the other ones have minor differences with the lighting change. While plastic doesn't really change at all, smooth plastic becomes a tad bit glossy, and as you can see, it reflects a little bit more light with these new settings. If you want some of the shadows to be sharper or feathered out, you can also adjust the shadow softness in the properties of lighting right here. So right now I have it at 0.5, but if I drag it all the way down to 0, you'll see that they start to become a little bit more sharp, and if I go back over here and I drag it more to 1, they become more rounded and harder to distinguish. This is normally at 0.5, so I'm gonna bring it back there. Anyways, I'll let you guys get experimenting with this new Roblox lighting. If this helped you out, don't forget to like the video and consider subscribing so I know you want to see more. If you have any additional questions or suggestions, please be sure to let me know in the comment section below. Hope you all have a fantastic rest of your day. I'll see you all later.